I have to drop the hammer, but I have built enough rapport because I understand why they're needing to sell this place, all these kinds of things. And to transition into that conversation, sometimes that's not my strength. So how do you, from kind of like a mindset approach or just some practical advice about moving into that place where you got all this rapport and good favor, and then you're going to jump into giving them the number?
I don't know if I want to reveal. This is a million-dollar secret he's asking me right now, Brent. Do I have to share everything?
Don't leave a single stone. There's no way you can cover all the guts. You've written like 18 books in that one question.
Oh
I think
man.
that's just a piece of it for me. I don't want to ruin the relationship. I don't want to lose my friend that I just made. I used to do that dance for days and months sometimes on real estate deals.
Okay. I mean, how many people want me to share this secret of mine? See, nobody. Nobody's raising their hand. Nobody wants to know. See,
You gotta
what?
come. We need a few more people to come on camera. Wait, I don't know if these are real people.
Here we go. So you're in a. Let me ask you this. It kind of go a little background here. Your whole business is based on getting a significant discount on every property.
Yes, that's the
Okay.
only way it works.
Well, does it? Let me ask you. Does it? Can I use three words in every conversation: price or terms. And then I'm so transparent with the prospect. I even explain it to him, sir. I'm an investor. I represent other investors and everything. And we need to make a profit. Where the only thing I can offer you is if you can discount the property 18% today, I can close very quickly. But I don't want to insult you. How do you feel about that, sir? You probably want a higher price or something.
No, I want 400,000 for my
400,000,
property.
and that's a reasonable price for the comps in the neighborhood and everything, right?
No.
Okay. And you know what? If I was in your position, I would feel the exact same way. You want full price when for your prop, that's full market price, correct?
No. The town's just growing. It's
Yeah.
28 acres, so.
Absolutely. So let me ask you this. Imagine for a moment I gave you full price on the property, but I asked you for some reasonable terms. You own the property free and clear, I assume, right? Okay. I'll make you an offer. I want the property for five. I'll give you $400,000 for the property if you hold a note for 4 years, interest-only payments with a balloon at the end. Can we do business today?
How do I, because I got this objection when I pitched that. How do I know you're not going to go bankrupt?
Now, you know
I mean, it
what?
sounds good.
Great question. Whatever they say, what is the traditional salesman? How do they react psychologically when the prospect gives them a stall or an objection? Do they get to fit? Go ahead.
Explain. You get into an explain mode.
Yeah, they go in explain mode. They go back to their presentation. They get defensive, right? Okay, they get defensive. And the thing about it is, in guts, you have to understand, it's a very powerful word I'm going to teach you guys right now. It's called empathy. What are they thinking? What are they feeling right now? He's worried about me going bankrupt, him getting into a whole legal issue and everything. Is that unreasonable? If with tables were turned, would you guys feel the same way? What do you think? Yeah. So I go back to him, and this is where stroking, nurturing, and empathy come. I'll come back. Can I call you Martin? I'm Claude, by the way, Mr. Rubel. Oh, you know what? If I was in your position, I would feel the exact same way. So if you had a certain, let me ask you this, sir. And it's okay to say no to me, but if you had a certain amount of security and you knew that I was a man of my word and you knew that your payments were going to be made, there was going to be no bankruptcy to a substantial certainty, that wouldn't make a difference, would it?
Yeah, I just want to make sure, that I get my money at the end of the
Good for
day.
you, sir. Good for you. What would you need from me in order to have that certainty? Credit? So
Yeah,
things like
maybe
credit? How would you like?
maybe a good down payment, and then
The
I'd
down
like to
payment, okay.
at least understanding what happens
Would you
if
like some
yeah.
references too? I've been in business for a while. Would you like to speak to some people I've done business with?
Oh yeah, that'd be good.
Okay, so just to sum up, sir, if I understand correctly, you do a credit check on me and also my company. If you know that You checked my references and everything else. And there was one more you gave me. What was it?
No, some sort of money down,
A
something like
money
that.
down payment, a reasonable down payment. We wouldn't be able to do a contract today, would we?
Well, I'd have to kind of do my research on you.
Okay. So if you did, let's assume everything remains good credit, good references, reasonable down payment. I can get you a letter of credit from the bank and I could get that all to you. What happens when we speak tomorrow at 10 o'clock?
I mean, if you can get that to me, I probably just have to read it over and then maybe we can do something.
Is that maybe yes or maybe no?
Maybe yes.
Okay, what do I need to do to get a real yes out of you? All things to your sub to a substantial certainty, all the things that I just proposed, could we do that deal?
Yeah, I mean, I just have to make some calls on your references and just double
And
check
let's
that.
say they're the best in the world. They tell you I walk on water and I only eat In-N-Out burgers, okay?
Well, I think then at that point we maybe could do the next deal.
Okay, maybe what do I need to do to get you to yes, sir?
Yeah, I mean, maybe come out here and take a look at the property and
I've seen it already. I got an Air Force
yeah.
drone that flew over it. It's
Yeah, I
we
just
love
don't I
we love the property. We have the money, we have the credit, everything else. I just don't want to go through all the time trouble, the contracts and everything else. Then you tell me tomorrow you're going to think about it or your wife's mad at you.
Yeah, I have to talk to her too.
Sir, I'm ready to do business, but if you'd rather say no, now's the time to do it.
It's definitely a yes. I just need
What?
to.
I'm
I
sorry,
just.
what? What?
It's a yes. I just need
Oh,
to. I just need.
okay. Give him
I
a
just
round of
need
applause. That was a great
to.
role play. How long did it take for me to get Martin to say a real yes? How many times did we have to go around? Did you guys
See,
hear? Oh.
Claude, what I struggle with is like I know they're lying to me, but I don't the like the discomfort I feel in leaning in
Get over it.
is okay.
You know how
Because
you
like
get,
I
you know how you
because
get
I
over.
yeah, just get over it. Yeah.
I always imagine my little children sitting on the breakfast table naked with swollen bellies and no milk in the refrigerator. What's more
Okay.
important?
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. And the other thing I thought you didn't hit me at the 400. You didn't hit me with a cash, right? Because generally we've hit people with cash, but then sometimes this is why I like the LOLs because it does it for me. Which again, kind of going back to Brent's thing, it does it for me. So they're usually negotiating from a number. But when I send out the neutrals letters, I get more of this kind of conversations, and I've been getting good responses, but I've not closed as many contracts. I think because I've just been, I don't want to hit them with the hey, I got to buy this thing probably at 250 for cash.
Okay, good. Well, let's do this. Hey, Mr. Ramirez, can I make you an offer?
Yeah.
And you promise you won't get mad at me? I'm sorry?
What do you
Oh,
got?
okay. Okay, I know you want 400,000 and I need the property for 318.5.
Oh,
I knew you'd get mad at me. Oh gosh.
it's
Do
way
you know
too
what?
low.
Yeah, it's low. But you know what? Okay, would you like to get this thing done without a realtor? Quick close, 30 days. Because we can do, if you and I can meet on that price, I can make a commitment right now. Imagine for a moment you got this thing sold, you got a check in your hand, and it's done. How would you feel about that?
Yeah, no, that would feel pretty good,
What
but
should we do?
I don't know if I can take that big of a haircut,
Hmm. Who could?
I don't know.
I love the silence, by the way. What happens when there's silence? What should you do?
Shut up.
Yeah. Good role play. The thing about that role play is, promise you won't get mad at me. And then,
And I know it, and I know it, and I think it's just some tough love. Just get over it, put on your big boy pants, and just do it.
you've got a pen there, Martin. Everybody,
Yeah.
get your pen out. Write these letters down. IDGASL. IDGASL. It's my new amusement park. It's between Universal Studios and Disneyland. It's called I Don't Give a Shit Land. Okay, you get to a point. What's the worst that could happen, Martin?
Yeah.
What's the
They
worst
say
that can happen?
they hang up.
Yeah. It can, listen, you got it. That's why I use the price or terms. I also use options a lot of times. I love options because they're non, I don't, I don't have to go through with the deal. I have an escape plan if I want to get out of it.
Think about this though. You could be a little cocky, but if you're using stroking and nurturing enough, they're going to feel like you're a true leader and you're going to get this deal done rather than some subservient person on the other end that they don't feel that they lack confidence in. It's almost like it if I needed help really quickly and I needed to, if I needed to sell a piece of land or a house fairly quickly, I would want a leader on the other end of the phone telling me, you know, this is how I usually get these deals done, rather than someone that's super nice and just they don't have the confidence to even get the deal. Because I think that's how I've closed a lot of deals. It's just I give them the confidence that I will get it done no matter what. And there's been a few deals where the seller should have canceled on me. It took me months to get it done, but they hung in there. Something helped made them hang in there. I don't know what it was, but I think I know now. It was just they felt the confidence that I was gonna climb mountains to get it done. So we're worried about them hanging up on us or getting mad at us. That's probably not our land seller. We can't buy everyone's land or everyone's houses. But the ones that truly need our services, our convenience, our speed, our time, our terms, they're probably going to hear us out. And especially if you say, listen, you promise you won't get mad at me, and you stroke and nurture them, but you also have that like that New Yorker, I don't ESL
People
attitude.
talking to me or what?
They might I think they'll hang on, you know. I mean I think it's a fine line. You're really an actor.
You're
You know,
very
that's
good. You're a thespian. You're using the psychology, the way you ask questions, and like you said, the stroking, or but you're also playing a role. Okay. You're playing a role. It's over. I think a lot of salespeople bail out. They get an objection or a stall. Oh, okay, I understand you're busy. Listen, okay, I'll call you another time. Goodbye. I don't do that. Okay. I know you, hey, Mr. Bowers, I know you're busy and everything, but I'm ready to do a deal today, right now. So if you can find a way to spend a few more minutes on this phone, you might make a lot of money or
yeah,
lose.
I am pretty busy. I gotta go pick the kids up here soon. But yeah, I mean, I'm tired of people wasting my time about this land. I get these letters all the time. You know, what do you got?
Great question. Thank you, and I appreciate it. I know what it's like to pick up the kids, and I same thing and everything. You got boom. Now we're into it. Now I set the agenda real fast. I'm going to ask you a couple questions. You ask me a few. Let's see if we can do a deal. Then I go to qualification, and I learn. I ask the right. Why are you selling this property? What's your price? What's the term? You know, boom. Are you the person who can make the decision on the thing? What's your time frame? Do
I
you
got to
want?
talk to my wife. She's definitely the boss here. It's,
Check
you
with
know.
money. Honey, is it okay if I give Mr. Bowers a really big check before August 30th? My wife said it's okay. I
right.
really do. I really do this shit on the phone. They either laugh or hang up, by the way. I have a lot of my take on sales is how can I make it fun and go to the bank?
And I think one thing I'm also, again, getting from this book right now, I love the refresher. I'm on page like 30. I just got it yesterday in the mailbox. But as entrepreneurs, as business people, our number one priority is to protect our confidence. I think you can do that when you're joking around and being that IDGASL. And having fun with it. Oh my goodness. I got an objection yesterday. They came off the Wholesaling Inc. podcast. He asked me questions for 15 minutes, and at the end, I forgot to ask one of the questions you just asked. Is this just your decision, or how do decisions work in your business? I forgot that question, and he hit me at the very end. 15 minutes, just gave my heart and soul to this person, and I'd already been coaching for an hour on the Wholesaling Inc. Support call, and then he texted me, so I called him immediately. And at the very end, he's like, "I gotta ask my partner." And blah blah blah, and I said, okay, great. Like maybe now is not the best time. get back with me by tonight. Hey, is it okay if I give him my godfather offer? Gave him a godfather offer. And then the guy had the nerve at the very end, to ask me. He said, well, now that your internet's back up, can you check out this property for me? I said, no, and hung up.
That, you know, I when I was learning from my mentor, who taught me, Max, who taught, and I've written, Max is in this other book that I wrote. It's on my webpage. If you guys want it, you know, just contact me at that link in there. But I went to Max. I said, these damn prospects, I just got in my car. I drove through 2 hours of San Diego traffic to get to this appointment on this property, and the guy was late. And then he didn't show up. And then he told me he's not the owner of the property. He's got a contact and everything. And I had to drive 2 hours back through traffic and everything. And I wasted a whole day with this guy. And my mentor goes to me, he says, you know, there's no bad prospects. There's only stupid salesmen. And he said, did you, what, before you waste all that time, didn't you think maybe you had the right to qualify that prospect and find all this out before you threw away a day in your life? And talk about getting constructive criticism. Okay. Talk about learning from someone who's done it already. That's the
Sometimes we're
best
just so
policy.
excited. Sometimes we're just so excited to get a lead and, go check out the land. And it's because it's like, oh man, the leads are not coming in very often. It's my first deal. I got to do a deal. So I'll look, I want to swing the bat, but I get it.
I had a guy we met at a restaurant and everything. I thought I had a hot prospect, just like what you said, hot prospect. Met at the restaurant. Oh no, let me pick it up and everything like that. And we talked for an hour and a half, whatever. Oh, see, and he goes to me at the end after I pick up the check. He says, Claude, this is so great. I love this and everything. If I had the money, I would do it right now. He says, but I'm going to, what are you going to do? But I'm going to save up and I'm going to find the money or something like that. And I said, what are you going to do? Rob a 7-Eleven? I wasted another whole day and I bought somebody dinner because I didn't have the brains to find out. Hey, if we can do business today, do you have the down payment? Do you have the option money? Do you have the credit? How do you normally do business? How do you normally make decisions? This is important. I wrote something called the Salesman Bill of Rights. Do we have the right to ask these questions up front before we expend our time, our knowledge, our energy, or driving in traffic? Do we have that right? Somebody say yes, please.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
One of the aggravations I have now is I've been selling a lot of land. I use realtors to sell my land, but one thing that's helping me sell it is Facebook Marketplace. And I get all these questions all day long. Is this available?
I
And
don't
I
know.
just so reply, I don't know. That
I
I
don't know
because
why you wouldn't be. I could check for you. You wouldn't be interested in doing business today if it was, right?
I like that. I'm just going to copy and paste that because I have been replying with, yes, how many acres are you looking for? Because I've got many of these parcels that I'm selling, but I like that. I don't know. You wouldn't. Will you say that again?
Here's the logic behind it, and I'll do the role play. We want to turn the prospect into the salesperson. What is the sale? Who does most of the talking in traditional sales?
Salesperson.
Yak, 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 right? If you can get the prospect to become the salesperson, and you do this through the gut system, hey, tell me, why do you don't really want to sell this, right? Or why do you sell it? Oh, I have to sell it. I got to pay off some bills and everything. They'll qualify themselves. They'll give their own presentation. They might even close themselves. And it's really wonderful when you're sitting back and the prospect is doing all the work. So in your scenario, someone texted you or in Facebook, right?
Yeah, Facebook Marketplace. I think it's a button they can hit, and it's always like, I get so many of these things. Is this available? Is this still available? I'm just like, oh my God.
I don't know. I can check. Are you ready? Is this something you could do today if it was? Then you find, well, I don't have the money. I'm just looking. I don't this and that and everything. Save a lot of time if you find, I could check that for you. Hey, why don't you come online? Why don't you come on? Wait, on Facebook Messenger, you can go live right away, can't you? I've done that.
Yeah, you can hit the call button.
Yeah. Hey, let's talk right now. Let me check if I have it available. I have some other, boom. You got